myself, Emilio, Murga, Luis Ramirez, Jack Cuateco. This is our Rube Goldberg project for the English 154 Physics 211 workshop with Dr. Avery. As you can see, we have a ramp here.
This cup connected to a pulley connects to another ramp, followed by another ramp, followed by a final ramp. It comes down and it knocks the dominoes over.
Spelling E-C-S-T.
Yeah, yeah.
Engineering, computer science, technology. Here we go. How about that?
First plan.
Is that what we're gonna call it? So, as you can see here, the distance is 0.38 meters. Ball has to travel before it goes to the pulley. We calculated using a stopwatch, it takes 1.1 seconds. And so, starting at rest, its initial velocity is 0.0 meters per second. Find the final velocity. We've already calculated it. I'll just show you how we did it. We started with this kinematic equation, figure F. Changed it to figure out final velocity. Plugged in the numbers that we knew. Final velocity is 0.69 meters per second. We also wanted to find acceleration. You can see we've already finished that here, but if you come with me, you'll see the final velocity kinematic equation derived it for the acceleration. Plug in the numbers, you get 0.63 meters per second squared. So now we're on to the pulley. As you can see, we have mass one, which is the can and the ball, and mass two, which is a bird, but we decided to draw a key. I don't know if you've seen the first Harry Potter. It might make sense. I don't know. Whatever. Anyways, so the mass of the ball in the can is 4.6 times 10 to the negative 2 kilograms. Breaking it down right here. And the mass of the bird, the little bird, the counterweight, 6.8 times 10 to the negative 3 kilograms. Obviously, the key's going to come back up, bringing the can with the ball back down. You want to swing it over a little bit this way. Obviously, mass one, the can with the ball, is greater than mass two by a lot. Make tension equal to each other to figure out acceleration. 7.2 meters per second squared. Once again, with the tension force. So we have tension force, M1 times G, M1 times A. We're looking to get tension force. Plug in all the numbers that we know. We get the first tension force equals 1.2 times 10 to the negative 1 newtons. And looking for the second tension. So we have the second mass times gravity, also times acceleration. Plug in all. Oh. That's weird. I think physics is calling. Hello? Oh, yeah, he's not here right now. Yeah, I'll let Avery know that you called. Yeah, I'm sure he'll really appreciate that. Okay, all right, yeah, I gotta get back to this presentation. Okay, all right, bye. So, after we plug everything in, second tension equals 1.2 times 10 to the negative 1 newtons. If I were to, you know, expand it out, you would see that they're slightly off. Tension 1 is a little bit greater than tension 2, but not by much. That's it. Okay, so now we're going to figure out the, after the pulley drops onto the second ramp, we're going to assume that our initial velocity is at rest. I guess it is momentarily, but it It's 0.41 meters. It takes 0.62 seconds to travel down. It's at a decline of 20 degrees. So we start plugging it in. There's our equation to get final velocity. Find out that our final velocity is 1.32 meters per second. We plug it into the kinematic equation to figure out acceleration. We find out that the acceleration going down the ramp is 2.13 meters per second. The following ramp is also the same, all the same calculations, just in a different direction.